Hi guys, this is Zoro. The video of today will be a comparison video. We will chop some oak here, and this tree right here is dead, as you guys can see. I have cut this one right here few years ago, so this is dead, very dead. And also the tree over there, also oak, is dead. And I'm always in the most uncomfortable position. I'm in a downhill, so the ground is something like 40-45 degrees in pendence. And yes, that's why I'm holding my phone with one hand, and with the other one I was hoping to show to you some chopping. We will start with my newest addition to the collection, which is the RS7 made by Giuseppe Lovaglio. And yeah, sorry for the camera, but the light is not quite good. And yes, because I'm in the shadow, but there is the sun, so it will be difficult maybe for the phone to actually, yes, it's difficult to see well all the details of the knife. Okay, we will go right here. Oak, dead oak, which is quite tough wood, and well, stay still in this position. I will show the other comparison, which is about the TRC Apocalypse. I don't know if you can see well, but the RS7 is bigger. It's actually longer. That's not a good. Okay, let's see. Yes, now you can see maybe well. The RS7 is longer than the TRC Apocalypse, and the Apocalypse is thicker on the spine. This is the DBK edition, convex to zero. And maybe on the ground will be better. The price is almost the same for these two knives. Yeah, the RS7 is bigger, longer. Okay, it's longer and largest and bigger than the TRC Apocalypse, but this is balanced in this spot right here, so it's behind the guard, almost in the hole. It's his balance point. So this one is a multi-roll, some sort of type of knife. This one is wood, while the TRC Apocalypse is balanced forward of the guard. So in the hole, if I put my finger right here, it will go down because of the balance point, which is, I believe, right here. So in front of the guard, and that's why this one is a chopper, so a survival, some sort of camp knife, while the other one, even if it's bigger, it's not. And other differences, this one is sabre, then convex to zero. This one is full flat with the micro bevel. This one is Leipner, which is carbon steel. This one is Helmax, which is a inox steel. So even if this knife have the same price and some sort of a high quality fit and finishes on all the details, those two knives are quite different, and on the steel materials, grind, thickness, heavy, and also destination of use, because this one is a survival camp knife and this one is not, it's some sort of multi-roll. So this one will be better, in my opinion, for cut, even in kitchen, hunting, etc, etc. And this one will be better, that's my opinion, we will try, of course, this one will be better for chopping and bathooning, because of the grind, thickness and the balance point, which is very different. But yeah, it's also funny that these two have also different sheath, because this one is a Kydex with Cordura loop and this one is a custom high quality leather sheath. So they are both different in all the details, and this one is G11 and this one is Micarta. So they can seem to a non-expert guy quite similar knife, but those are very, very different. This one is a custom, this one is semi-custom, but I would say high quality factory knife with some sort of handmade finishes, such as maybe the convex grind and the other details on the blade. So very, very different knife. And let's go now some shopping. We will go right there with the Apocalypse. I mean, the Apocalypse is so much more powerful in chopping than the other one. This cut is deeper and bigger with half of the time, I can say. But let's finish this one right here with the RS7. We are almost there. Come on. Okay. We make it at the end. And the balance point is so important for chopping. And yes, now that we have done that, I believe that we can do some strikes over there. Let's see with the 10 chops. I have already done 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's go with 20. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So of course this is a big, very big piece of oak, and it seems that someone is living inside. Yeah, now there will be peace, but I don't care. Now I will go in the same wood, a little bit higher maybe, and we will do the same thing, 20 hits with the TRC Apocalypse. The BK edition. 2, 4, 5. As you guys can see, the Apocalypse is much heavier and goes deep into the wood thanks to the grind. Okay, I will was 3 or 4. Let's say 4. 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, almost 20, maybe, or also maybe I was distracted by the ant, but maybe you guys can see well the difference in the penetration and between those two knives. And yes, now those ant are peace. Sorry guys, I was saying that the ant are peace. And let's go. How can I show it to you? Maybe with one strong hit right here. That's the penetration of the blade in the wood with one hit. So that is the force of the convex grind with the balanced forward grind. Let's go again with the RS7. One hit. It's not bad, but it's not at the same level. I wasn't able to